Good morning, everyone. I, Kanchan Khatreja, Assistant Professor, School of Education, K.R. Mangalam University, Gurugram, welcome you all in second day of 1 week interdisciplinary faculty development program on meaningful research and intellectual property rights. The topic for today's session is systematic approach for writing research articles, indexing and citations. Writing a research paper or article is the primary channel for passing on knowledge to researchers working in the same field or related fields. It is important to hone the skill of writing papers to demonstrate your ability to understand, relate to what has been learned, as well as receive critical peer feedback. During our career, our publications find a valuable place in our resume, and they showcase our accomplishment and communication skills, eventually being a permanent segment of the ever-increasing regime of knowledge. Indexing and citation is essential in research papers, articles, as it makes each writing more realistic as well as valuable. Citation indexes allow researchers to trace the impact of an article upon later publications as well. Therefore, it is very important to understand the systematic approach for writing research articles for our professional group. It is my great honor to introduce our today's guest and speaker. I want to take this opportunity to introduce our distinguished guest and speaker for this session. Today's speaker is Dr. A.V. Senthil Kumar. He is working as a director and professor in the Department of Research and PG in Computer Applications, Hindustan College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. He has, to his credit, 19 book chapters, 208 papers in international and national journals, 53 papers in international and national conferences, and 10 edited books in and textbooks. Sir is an editor-in-chief for various journals. He is key member for India Machine Intelligence Research Lab. Sir is associate editor of IEEE Access. Sir is an editorial board member and reviewer for various international journals. Sir is also a committee member for various international conferences. Sir is a life member of International Association of Engineers, System Society of India, member of the Indian Science Congress Association, member of Internet Society, International Association of Computer Science and Information Technology, Indian Association for Research in Computing Science, and committee member for various international conferences. Sir has received various awards. A list is very long. I would like to announce the few of them. Sir has received Shiksha Ratan Puraskar Award in November 2008. Sir also received Global Teacher Role Model Award 2015 from MVLA Trust, Mumbai. Sir has also received Outstanding Educator Award, Excellent Technosoft Coimbatore 2018. Sir also selected for Rabindranath Tagore Samman, Vidya Ratan Award, Rajiv Gandhi Excellence Award, and many more. So, sir, looking to forward to see you in our today's session, and would like to take your knowledge to wisdom, and so that our participants can learn from you. So we have our Dean Ma'am with us, Dr. Sanya Gupta Ma'am, School of Education, K.R. Mangalam University. I would like to invite our ma'am. Please say a few words.
Thank you, Ms. Kanchan, the FGP coordinator, and my regards also to the other two versatile faculty of our department, Dr. Anshul Saluja and Ms. Manju Kundu, who are organizing this FGP. At the outset, on behalf of School of Education, K.R. Mangalam University, Gurugram, and the Faculty of Education, CCS University, Meerut, which are collaborating for this faculty development program on meaningful research and intellectual property rights from 8th of August to 14th of August 2022. I extend a warm welcome on behalf of our university as well as CCS Meerut University, the organizers, to Professor Dr. A.V. Senthil Kumarji. So thank you so much for consenting to be a part of this FGP. It's often that we keep hearing about, you know, the valuable sessions that you keep taking across the country. You know, you have a rich command over this topic, and we really we could not have found someone better than you for this. And we are hopeful that today the participants are going to immensely gain from the topic that you have consented to deliberate upon today, which is systematic approach for writing research articles, indexing and citations. Just to brief you, we have a lot of professors, associate professors, assistant professors, and scholars who are a part of this FGP. So welcome again, sir. And we look forward to be informed learners. And I hope that the session after your your deliberations, it comes interactive with a lot of questions from the participants, and they gain a lot of value. So welcome once again, sir, on behalf of our university and CCS University, Meerut. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
So I think, sir, we can now listen to you. So we'll stop sharing our screen, and sir, you can you can go ahead with sharing your screen, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, please take your time, no issues.
And can you provide, allow me to just use my slide, ma'am? Ma'am, can you allow me, ma'am, just to share my slide? Can you give permission?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Ma'am, is it audible? Ma'am, can you give me permission to use my slide, ma'am, please? I'm not able to see my screen, ma'am.
Sir, just kindly give us...
One sir.
Yes,
sir. Okay, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
It's done, sir. Please check it again.
So you have been given the host rights?
Yes, ma'am. Previously, I was able to see. Now, I am not able to see with that particular PPT.
I think, sir, as a host, you need to promote the other... by Dr. A.V. Senthil Kumar. You have to make that particular name as host.
One second.
Yes, sir. Because I can see that you're joined from two devices, I guess. Sir, you must be able to see participants at the bottom of the screen.
Yes, ma'am. I'm able to see, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Previously, it was showing now, ma'am. Before this one, I was able to see.
So, shall I help you with promoting the other by your name as host?
Yes, ma'am. Please, ma'am.
Yes, sir. You will be able to see participants written at the bottom of the screen.
Yes, ma'am. I can see, ma'am. I can see the participants.
There is an arrow, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Please click on that arrow, sir.
I see the arrow, but I'm seeing only this FDP on meaningful research and IPR.
All right. Just click on the participant, sir.
Any participant, huh?
Yes.
Can I click on? No.
Panelist?
No, I'm clicking.
First
panelist.
Click, then click panelist. Then click panelist.
Once again, ma'am. I wish I gave you clicking this share screen. Okay. What I should do?
Can you see panelists written in blue?
No, ma'am.
Sir, I'm sharing my screen.
Okay.
Done? So we have to click this participants. Then this panelist. So I cannot make that. Sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, ma'am.
Sir, please, after clicking on the participants, you will be able to see this window.
No, I'm not able to see the participants, ma'am. Just I'm not able to see it. But in the mobile, I can see this. Now it's okay. Now it's staying. Just I'm not able to see this. Now you're visible, ma'am. Your video is visible in my mobile. But my desktop, it's not visible, ma'am.
Just helping you. Just wait. Wait.
Sir, actually, you are host from two IDs.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Now I'm my desktop. I'm using avsenthilkumar2007@gmail.com. Can you give permission for that? avsenthilkumar.
Okay. Okay, sir. Okay.
Sir, now you can share the screen.
No, it's not listing. Select a window screen. It's not visible, ma'am.
Sir, you can share your screen.
Which one? No, I'm sharing. Now I'm sharing. One second.
What
do you see? No, I shared my screen, ma'am. I shared, ma'am.
PPT is not visible, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Just I shared now. But the thing is, when I enter this, I'm not able to share window or screen. It's not showing that my screen, ma'am. You should give permission, please, I think, sir.
Please share your PPT with us.
When I enter the share screen, it's not showing the particular window, ma'am. Yeah. So before this introduction, no, just
so you are able to keep see. Your PPT open.
Open, yes, ma'am. It's open. My PPT is open now.
So if possible, you can share your PPT with us. You can mail us. We will present on your behalf. And
1 second. One second.
Sir, have you shared the PPT?
Now, just 1 second, please. Okay, now just 1 second, it's loading. I'll check it, ma'am. Just
okay, sir. No problem. Sir, first open the PPT, then you can share the screen.
It's showing entire screen. Now it is opening.
Okay.
1 second. I have opened, ma'am.
Not yet, sir.
Hello, ma'am.
Not yet, sir.
So it is in my desktop, ma'am. Now I open the screen. Okay.
When you click the share screen, there will be a PPT. You can share that PPT.
Okay. Okay, I click the share screen now.
Yes. When you click that screen,
I click the share screen.
Then you can see your PPT. Click on the PPT.
I click.
Click that PPT.
That's
all. No.
Stop saying PPT.
On your desktop, it might be a PPT.
Yes, ma'am. I opened the PPT, ma'am.
When you click share screen,
my PPT is on the screen. So open.
But we are not able to see the PPT, sir. You have started screen sharing, but there is some logo that we can see. Can you share that PPT on us with our mail ID?
Just send it in the email. I sent it already to you, this Archana. I already sent it. Please check it now.
Sir, we have not received your PPT. You can send us again, please.
You check your Archana, that email, you know. Just 1 second.
Email ID is anshul.saluja@krmangalam.edu.in.
Have you received, ma'am?
No, sir.
I'm sorry for this. I send it to you, sir.
anshul.saluja at krmangalam.edu.in.
It has been said, ma'am, you have received a justice. Have you received it, ma'am? Hello?
Not yet, sir.
Hello?
Not yet, sir.
Please, I have sent it already. It is the sent folder, ma'am.
Okay, sir. We'll check again.
Please, Anshul Savija in the immunity. Anshul Savija at KR Mangalam.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, we didn't receive till now.
Once again, I'll send you.
Sir, we haven't received your PPT.
One second. Attaching now, ma'am, please. I'm sending from Gmail now, once again. Sorry, ma'am. Sorry, just. Just a network connection. Just reconnect it once again, ma'am.
Click on share screen, sir.
One second, please, ma'am, please.
You can see your PPT on different.
The thing is, the network connection has to be on. Just one second, ma'am.
If you click on your PPT and then share. Select that window.
Just one second. I'm opening it, one second. Please, ma'am. I think it's just.
Can you,
ma'am? Please, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. No, it's come, ma'am. Please, ma'am. Check it, ma'am. Now it is able processing, please, ma'am. No, can you check it? It's open.
We didn't get you, sir.
Now it's opening.
Then nothing is visible on the screen. Ma'am, check it, ma'am. You have received this, ma'am. Please, ma'am. PPT, you have received the PPT, ma'am. Please, ma'am. Okay, sir. Okay, we'll see. No, sir, we didn't receive mail. We didn't receive the PPT on the mail, sir. Sir?
I want to send. I'll send both from your Gmail as well as Yahoo. Please check it, ma'am. I'll send two times.
Sir, on which mail ID you have sent?
That is Anzul Saluja, ma'am.
Sir, it's anshul.saluja.
Yes, ma'am. Same. I just forwarded it to you.
anshul.saluja@kml.edu.
Yes, same. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, sir. We'll check it again. Sir, we have received your PPT. Just give us a second. We are
going okay, to okay, okay, screen. Okay, please, ma'am. Please, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay. Ma'am, now you're able to see the screen, ma'am, please.
Yes, sir, we can see.
Start again. Sorry, start now. Please, ma'am. It's okay, ma'am, I can start now.
Sir, please start. Please start.
Okay. Once of all, thank you. So, once of all, I should say sorry for all. Due to this network problem, I was not able to connect the system. So, I take this opportunity to thank the patrons, co-patrons, conveners and coordinators of School of Education and Faculty of Education, KR Mangalam University, for giving this great opportunity. So I'll start my presentation. So before entering to this, how to publish or how to make citations and how to make indexing, all these things, you should think why you should publish. What is the purpose of publishing papers or articles in journals or publishing any book? So before entering all these things, we should know why you should publish. So if you publish something, that may be a book or any paper in a journal or any articles in a magazine, it improves your writing skill. It helps in knowledge upgradation. Your knowledge will be upgraded. It keeps you updated. Whatever new things is happening in the field, in a particular field, you will be updated. It teaches you how about literature survey, what is happening, what are the new things are going on, what are the things before it has been done in your area, all these things. Apart from this, it makes you happy. If something is published in your name, sure, it makes you happy. It also helps the society with your research work. Whenever you do any research work, it helps the society. You will get some appreciation for your work, what you have done. You'll also get publicity to your work. If your work is an innovative or a new one, sure, your name will be published, or you'll get more publicity in your area or in world. Apart from this, you'll get some value for your name. It keeps you alive as a researcher. So if you're interested in publishing something, sure, you'll be going on researching, doing something in your area. You'll alive as a researcher. It also motivates others to research. Your work, if it's a new thing or innovative one, sure, it makes others to continue your research work. Above all, you can also earn money. So many of our professors doesn't know how to earn money in our academic field. If you publish some work, or you publish any book, or if you publish any edited books, or you write some articles in a magazine, sure, you can earn money. You'll get some royalty for your work yearly. So if you publish your work, sure, you can also earn money as royalty for your publications. Okay. Whether I need any special talent to publish my articles? No. No need of any special talent to publish any book or edited book or any work in any journal. Just little interest. If you have some little interest in your field, sure, you can publish any articles or books. So, see a child. Nobody is making the child to walk. The child in its own interest tried to walk. So if you have some interest in your field, sure, you can publish any articles in magazines, or you can publish any books or any edited books. Okay, so this is some example of mine. I started publishing some articles during 90s. So see, this is a local newspaper in our area where I published some articles in 1990 December, okay. Then it's a local magazine where I published some articles. This is also during 92, I think so. I started my work in 90. I was going on publishing some works in magazines as well as newspapers. So this is a magazine, computer magazine, where questions will be raised by the readers. And I was answering for this computer related questions for more than 12 years in this magazine. So this made me to publish some works in books or edited books or publish articles in journals. Okay. So why citation is important? Why I need citations for my work? Okay. So if you're not publishing anything, for example, you have finished your research work or you are doing some research, you are not publishing anything, then you are in a mute position. Okay. You are doing some research or you are doing, you are in academic field. If you are not publishing anything, sure, you are in mute. Okay. Even though if you have published, if you are not, work is not cited by anybody, then your work is really, it's a waste one. It is like you're talking in a, you're making a speech in a speech, nobody is listening to your speech. Then what is the use? So when you publish something, sure, it should be read by others, more number of people, and it should be cited in their works. Generally, your publication is a good one or a valid one, or it is useful to others. So being not publishing anything is really like in a mute position. If your work is published, if nobody is reading, that means if nobody is citing your work in their works, then really it is like you're talking in a stage where nobody is listening to your speech. So citation is more important whenever you publish anything. Okay. Then why is, I should care whether anybody is citing my work or not? If I am publishing something, why I should care why others should cite my work? Okay. Only when you get more number of citations, then you can understand or you can realize your work is a good work or a useful work. So if your number of citations for your work is more, it means that your work is a good one. So citation impact is more important whenever you publish anything. So knowing your work is cited, it helps you to prepare for your confirmation. Suppose you are having more number of citations, sure, it would help for your job confirmation, your promotion application, your early performance appraisal. Apart from that, it improves your academic impact. So more number of citations will help for all these type of activities or things. So when you're paying attention to a number of citations, it means that you can know that who are all continuing your research work or who are all using your work as a base for the research work. So depending on the level of engagement with your work, these people might well be your future collaborators. Suppose you can identify some persons, if they are using your base work as a, for the research work, you can also contact them in, so that you can combinedly do some research work. So they may be your future collaborators. So apart from that, you can also get some new ideas from their work. Suppose if somebody are using your work as a base work for the research work, you can have their ideas so that you improve your research work. So you can also get some new ideas from your citations of your papers. Apart from that, more number of citations will give you your ego boost, nice ego boost. If your work is getting more number of citations, so you're sure you'll get more interest and your research work will be going on very high level. So it will give a nice ego boost for your research work. Okay. Now we can see what are the most top indices which are used for indexing the research works. The first one is Web of Science. You heard about this Web of Science. It is maintained by Clarivate Analytics. Okay, it mainly indexes journals of sciences, sciences, social sciences, arts, and humanities. The next one is Scopus. It is maintained by LSBO. It mainly indexes journals of type from medicine to computer science, social sciences, as well as humanities. The other one is AI Compendix. It mainly indexes engineering databases, the journals related to engineering research articles, as well as the engineering related publications. The other one is DOAJ. It mainly indexes online publications. Okay. The other one is BioOne. It mainly indexes journals of type biological, ecological, and environmental science journal contents. The next one is ACM Digital Library. It mainly indexes journals, conference proceedings, technical magazines, newsletters, as well as books. It mainly indexes, which covers computing and information science. The other one is ERIC, which mostly indexes education literature and its related resources. The next one is PubMed, which indexes journals related to biomedical literature, as well as biomedical books also. The other one is InSpec. It covers journals, proceedings, books, and other resources in the areas of physics, engineering, computing, and information technology. It is also maintained by Clarivate Analytics. The other one is PsycInfo, which indexes abstracts in the field of psychology. It mainly indexes psychology-related abstracts.
Sir, sorry to interview you, but slides are not moving.
One second. It's not moving, yeah? One second now.
We can see the slide. Why is citation impact important? So kindly,
I'm also seeing that, ma'am. One second, I'll check it, ma'am. Please. No, it's a, can you view it, ma'am, please?
Yes, sir, yes.
One second, sorry, sir. So this has various top indices. So one is Web of Science, Scopus, AI Competex, DOAJ, Bio1. The other things of ASM Digital Library, ERIC, PubMed, InSpec, as well as PsycInfo. Okay. Now we can see what is meant by ISSN number. So even though you know what is an ISSN number, just I'll give an introduction for this. So mainly ISSN number is used for the journals. Okay. If any journal is not having any ISSN number, it is not approved journal. So each and every journal should have an ISSN number. It's a worldwide identification code used by publishers, suppliers, libraries, information services, barcoding systems, etc., which is given for journals. So it is an international serials directory database. Okay, so international standard serial number. So each and every journal will have a serial number. It is an international standard serial number. It is known as an ISSN number. Actually, it's an 8-digit number. The first 7 digits will be some digit numbers. The 8th digit may be a number, or you can see an X in the particular 8th digit. Okay. So this 8-digit number, okay, when you consider this 8-digit number, it will be an ISSN number. In some cases, it will be an X at the last digit. So this X digit is to check that particular whether that particular ISSN number is a valid number or not. Okay. So there you go. I want to check that particular number. So suppose if an ISSN number of a journal is 0378-5955, okay, where the final five is the check digit. Okay. So in some cases, instead of the final digit 5, they may be mentioning it as X. So how to check that whether that particular 7 digits are valid ISSN number? So below that, I am showing that that is the first number 0 into 8. Because it's an 8-digit number, the first digit should be multiplied by 0. That is second digit by 7, third digit by 6. It goes on like this. Totally, I'm getting 160 for that 7 digits. Okay. So I should use the modulus of this sum is then calculated. The remainder is determined after dividing the sum by 11. You divide this 160 by 11. Okay, you'll get 14. The remainder is 6. So you add this 14 plus 6 divided by 11. If the remainder is 0, if there is no remainder, the digit is 0. Otherwise, the remainder value is subtracted from 11 to give the check digit. So 11 minus 6 is equal to 5. Now, if you get this 11 minus 6, the answer is 5, means then the particular digit is ISSN number is correct. So don't be confused. So ISSN number is given for a journal. It's an international standard serial number. It will be 8-digit number. Either 8 digits will be number or the last digit will be X. Okay. So if you want to check an ISSN number, whether that particular journal valid is an ISSN number is valid, I've given a link below, that is journalseeker.researchbib.com/action=ISSN checker. You can click that link. If you go to that website, if you type the particular ISSN number, see, this is a screen. In the ISSN number screen box, if you type the particular ISSN number and click validate, it will show whether the particular ISSN number is valid one or not. Okay, see, now it shows whether the particular number, ISSN number is valid or not. Okay, so you can also check, if you want to check a particular ISSN number of a journal is valid one or not, you can use that particular link. You can type that particular number in that particular ISSN number checkbox. If you click validate, it will show the numbers. You can see a green tick at the sixth serial number, ISSN number 0378 minus, that is -5955. It's a green tick. So this particular ISSN number is a valid one. Okay. Apart from that, there is also a 13 code ISSN number. It is mainly the other 5 digits are used for publishers for identifying their works. Okay, so leave it. So ISSN number, mainly ISSN number is of 8 digits. If it's a 13 digits, the remaining 5 digits is used by the publishers to check the publication type, whether the price or some other things. Okay. Next, what is an ISBN number? Most of you heard about this ISBN number. So each and every book should have an ISBN number. Only if that particular book has an ISBN number, then that book is a valid one. So it is an international standard book number. Okay. So initially it was started with standard book number, that is SBN, it's a 9-digit number initially, which is created by Gordon Foster. He's an emeritus professor of statistics at Trinity College, Dublin, for booksellers as well as stationers in 1965. So this standard book number is used to identify a particular book. No two or three books will have the same ISBN number. Initially, it started with a 9-digit number by Gordon Foster. Okay, see, SBN 34001381 is the initial 9-digit number given for a book. Next came this 10-digit number. It's an ISBN format, which was followed by International Organization for Standardization, ISO, in 1970 as an international standard. Okay, so it consists of 10 digits, nothing there. They have added a zero before this 9 digits. So now each and every ISBN number will be of 10 digit numbers. So the ISBN may be converted to an ISBN by prefacing the digit 0 before the ISBN number, that's all. So for example, the second edition of Mr. J.G. Reader Returns, published by Hoarder in 1965 as ISBN 340, 9 digits. Okay. Next, it indicates the publisher 0, but the 01381 indicates the publisher serial number assigned by the publisher, and 8 is a check digit. So by prefixing a 0, this can be converted to ISBN. So the SBN number can be converted into ISBN number by adding a 0 at the front of this SBN number, that's all. So since 1st January 2007, ISBNs have contained 13 digits, a format that is compatible with Bookland, European article numbers, which are 3 digits. So these, after 2007, these Bookland European article numbers were given 13 digits. But nowadays, we have this Indian books, we have, when we publish a book, it has only 10 digit numbers. So this is how to identify how they are using this ISBN number. So this last two is used for check digit. Okay. You can see the barcode price for the publishers, the publisher identifier, this 9 digit number. So this 978 tells us this is an ISBN. One identifies a country. So this 13 digit number, it used to show how this ISBN number is given for a book. So below that there will be 13 digits. Okay, so this ISBN number is mainly used to identify the publisher details as well as the country of the book, all these things. Okay. Now next we can see what's a DOI number. So we have seen how to identify an ISSN number, ISBN number, etc. Now we are going to see what is a DOI number. It is nothing but a digital object identifier. So each and every paper which is published in the journal should have a digital object identifier. How we are identifying a book or a journal, either by ISSN number or ISBN number, in the same way, each published article in a journal DOI number. It is nothing a digital object identifier. See, when you see any article published in a journal, it will be given a DOI number. For example, in the screen, I have shown an example for an Elsevier publication. It is rounded by using a circle. So DOI, some 10.10/16. So each and every publisher will be given a common DOI or some prefix. So they will add some object number or paper number after that. Okay. So each and every publisher of a journal will be given a unique DOI number, so they can extend that for their papers what they are publishing. So DOI number is assigned for identifying a paper published in a journal. Okay. Now next we can move how to increase the chance your work is cited. Suppose I have published my paper in any journal or any book or in an edited book or in any conference proceedings, for example. I want to increase my citations. That is, I want to make my work to read by more number of people. How to do this? So for this, I am using some 4 C's. The first one is competence. The second one is collaboration. The third one is care. And the fourth one is communication. First, we can see what is a competence. So when you consider any product, only if the product is a quality one, you will get more number of customers. In the same way, only if you publish some high quality work, you will get more number of readers. If you get more number of readers, sure, you will get more number of citations for your work. So try to publish high quality work. Okay. Although there are always exceptions, in general, a work without more quality will attract only few citations. And high quality, meaningful work is more likely to be cited more. So if your work is a high quality one, sure, you'll get more number of citations. The second C is collaborate. So try to collaborate with other professors or other researchers or any colleagues of your colleagues and publish papers. So what is the use or what is the purpose of having some collaboration? Okay. So when you see the picture, you'll get some collaborators, you'll get some more motivations, you'll get some more innovation ideas, you'll get some more planning, you'll have some team spirit, you'll have some strategy for your publications or for research. Okay. So collaboration often leads to better quality research. if you combine a work and do some work, sure, that particular work will have some quality. So try to publish some works by using some collaborators. Either they may be your professors or your colleagues or some research scholars or any people from other countries. Okay. So if you have some collaborators, you will get some complementary skills in areas where you are not that strong. So your collaborator will be interested in some other field. You will be interested in some other field. If you combine both of your ideas, sure, you'll get a new work. If your work is a new one, sure, you'll get more number of readers and more number of citations. So having a co-author also means that there is always someone to read your paper. So if you have a co-author, sure, your co-author will also read your work. The friends of your co-authors will read your work. You'll get more number of citations. Okay. Also, you'll get more number of reviews for your work, comments for your work, so that you can improve your work. And that particular work will be a quality output. Also, each other has their own network of academics that follow their work. So if you have some collaborator, your collaborator network will read, or they will use your work in their research work so that it will be gone extending or expanding so that your work will get more number of citations. So try to have some collaborate papers or publications. Next one is care. So this is the main thing. You should take some care. So when you see a doctor, you should take more care on the patient. Then only that person, patient will be confident or will get a good name on that particular doctor. In the same way, we are all our professionals. Okay. We make our profession a nicer place to be. So care for your own academic reputation and never engage in questionable practices. Whenever you publish something, it should not be a questionable one. It should be a quality one because we are all in an academic field. Nobody wants to use and cite the work of someone they don't respect. Suppose, for example, it's happening. If you are not respecting anything, nobody will take care of your work or nobody will read of your work and nobody will make your work to move to other places. So only when you respect others, you make some good relationship with others, sure, you'll get some more number of citations. So most importantly, care for others too. Be polite and considerate and say thank you when someone helps you. Suppose if you are getting some help from others, either it may be a lab person or your colleague or your professor or anybody, if you are getting any help for your research work, after the work is done, say simply a thanks for their work. Sure, it will help you in any one way. Keep the promises you make at conferences. Suppose when you are going to any conferences, you can meet many people in the conferences. Okay. Then what happens? You can give some promises so that we can combine and do some work, or I can use your work in my work and I can publish. If you are giving any promises, just you make the promises to become true, because we are all in a academic field. We are all good academic citizens. The thing is, you take more care among your, that is your working place. It's not moving. One second, ma'am, please. A network problem. One second. Ma'am, just I'll continue, then I'll show the slide. One second. A network problem, please. Ma'am, it's audible? Hello? Ma'am, is it audible? Ma'am? Hello? Is it audible, ma'am? Okay, one second. Okay. Take care when you're having some help from other researchers or your neighbor persons or professors around you. So once again, I'm looking just connecting once. Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, one second, ma'am. Ma'am, can you give this connection, ma'am, please?
You're audible, sir.
Okay, but I want to share this, ma'am. Just I'm not getting the screen, ma'am. Just I've logged in once again. Ma'am, I've logged once again. Can you give this connection to my AV Senthil?
Yes, sir, I'm assigning you the right, sir.
One second, please, ma'am. Ma'am, I could just, I'm not getting that particular screen, ma'am, please, ma'am.
Sir, you are already a host.
Okay, just what I'm thinking is, just I'm trying once, logged in once, but I'm not getting this, share the screen, that share option, ma'am.
You're not getting the share option, sir?
Yes, ma'am, please, ma'am. I'm getting only this mobile, this live. Just I want my AV Senthil Kumar 2007, ma'am, please.
Yes, sir. I'm looking at that.
Network problem, just one second. Okay.
Sir, I can see you being connected from one device only.
What one device? One second, ma'am. One second, just I'm fine. So network problem here. This I don't know what happened. One second. Okay. Just I'll show the slide till that I'll explain. The other one is the fourth C is what you want to make is you want to make your papers That is, it should be communicated to others.
I'm so sorry, sir, to intervene you in between, but your slides are not visible.
One second, just. Yes. So, yes, meantime, sir. Just I'm talking, so what I'm talking. Right. Okay, just the network, no, yes, for the system, the network is a problem, one second. Okay, I'll just continue, ma'am. So the other one is a communicate. Okay, so simply publishing something. If you are publishing a book, you are keeping it on your table. How nobody knows what you have published and what you have done. Your research work you have published, or the paper, the details of the paper you have published. So whenever you if you want to make your work to reach others, you should communicate that your work to, that is, you have published a book, you have published a paper in a journal, you have published a article in a magazine. So communication is the main thing, so that your work should reach others. Suppose if you are sitting in a particular place, you are keeping all your books in a roadway, suppose in a place where nobody is coming or nobody are able to see your work, then there is no use. So your work, either it may be a book or a journal, in a paper in a journal, or any article in a magazine, it should be, the details should be reached to others. So what are the ways where you can make your work to reach others? Once again, I'm joining. Once again.
So we have been trying to connect
just,
you as
just
a
one
panelist.
Second, ma'am. Just I got the connection. Now I'll connect it, ma'am, please.
Yes,
just
please.
Just I got
do,
the
sir.
Connection, please.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Let's got it. Now you try, ma'am, please, ma'am.
Yes, sir. I'm doing that.
So John is a panelist. I joined just
from the other device also, sir.
Just I'm connecting other device, please.
Yes, sir. It's visible.
Okay,
now.
Sorry. So once again, sorry for the disturbance. A network problem here. Just I'll continue.
Alright.
So the fourth C is this communication. Okay, see, you communicate. Okay. See here, this is probably the most important aspect of getting cited. Okay, cited. So only your work, when your work is communicated to others, the details of your work is communicated to others, then only you'll get more number of readers and more number of citations for your work. So the academics can't read and cite your work if they can't find it. So now nobody is interested to go to a library or go to a place where the books are kept for reading. So they need, all the work should come to that place. Okay. Only then only they will read your work. The previous days, when the researchers are doing some PhDs or some research work, they should go to a library where it is located apart from 400 kilometers or 500 kilometers. They will refer the books and they will do the research work. Nowadays, not like that. Everything should come to their place. Then only they will read your work. Okay. So your work should be made to reach others on the desktop. Then only you'll get more number of readers. So what are the ways where you can make your work to communicate or to reach others in a easy way? So the first one is, you create a personal website. If you have a personal website, then no need. You can add all your publication details, what you have done till date, and also you can put your future plan, what you are going to do in your research work. So this will make others to contact you. They can have some collaboration with you, or they can know what you have done, and your work can be cited by others. So create a personal website and put up all your publication details in your personal website. The second one is, make your research papers freely available online. So try to publish your works in an online journals. Maximum try to publish in online journals. It should be freely available. Some of the online journals are getting some money to log in and to read a particular work. So try to publish your work in a freely available to online. Then the next one is, at the very least, ensure that you have a Google Scholar citation profile. So try to have a Google Scholar citation profile. I'll just in the next slides, I'll tell you how to create a Google Scholar citation profile and add all your publication details. So you should have a Google Scholar citation profile. It helps ensures that everyone can find an up-to-date list of your publications. So in the later slides, I'll explain you about this Google Scholar citation profile. The next one is, you try to attend conferences. Maximum, you try to attend conferences, present your work and talk to people. So why I should attend conferences? It's a place where you can meet many people from around the world. You can interact with them. You can have some ideas what they are doing, and you can also explain what you're doing. Both of you can interact and you can get some ideas, and also you can get some confirmation whether you can combine and do some research work. We can do some publication combinedly, and whether we can continue our research work in future. So whenever you're going to a conference, you take your publication copies, what you have published, you try to give to others where you find in the conferences, so that the people who get the copies of your publications can refer your papers, and later on they can contact you and you can have some combined research work. So try to attend the conferences and present your work and interact with the people who are attending the conferences. This will help you improve in your citations. The next one is, if you're not, suppose I'm not able to attend a conference due to some money problem or due to some family problem or financial, something like that. Okay, there's an alternative way. You can use some social media. So try to have a Twitter account. You put all your publication details in your Twitter account and all your research work details in the Twitter account. So whenever somebody sees your work in the Twitter, they can contact you, and later on you can have people. So this research shows that 5 to 10 times you'll get more number of partners or collaborators in by using some social media apart from that attending a conferences. So try to use a Twitter account to tweet your research works. The next one is, you can have a blog. If you are really keen, start blog posts about your research. So create a blog, you put all your research details on that particular blog, you can send the blog to your email IDs, or it is very easy to identify a blog for others and to know about your research work. There are a lot of free blog sites you can to prepare a blog. You can use Wix, WordPress, LinkedIn, Weebly, Medium, Ghost, Blogger, Zimdo, except a lot of things. The blog posts, they are free, so that you can create a blog. You can put all your research work details in the particular blog. This is another way to improve your citations. Next. You can also use the old way, fashion way. Old, it's not a old, it's a gold way. You can also use your email contacts. If you have some set of email addresses, you can send your public, suppose if you're publishing some work, you can send the abstract of that work and what you've done in that work use through email IDs. Okay. It's not a old fashion. It is a good way to send all your publication works. Or suppose if you have done a new work, you can publish a new paper, you can send that paper through email IDs to your friends and colleagues or professors in other world, okay, around the world. Also, if you have any idea, new idea, you can send an abstract of the new idea through email IDs, so that if anybody is interested, they will contact you and you can have some collaborative work. That collaborative work will have a good publication, so that you will get some more number of citations. So when you're writing emails, don't write mass emails when you're distributing your work. So, and all, if all of this sounds unfair to you and makes you think, but surely if my work is good, academics should read and cite it. You can think, if my work is good, why I should do all these things? Why should publicity and name recognition do me that? I can only agree heartily. I can agree heartily, but in the normal way, in the current trend, it is not true. Only when you make your work to reach others, you'll get more number of readers or more number of citations. So some more tips to increase citation count. One is write high quality papers about sound research that is useful, novel, and interesting. So when you try to write when you're interested to write a paper, you try to write a high quality paper that is useful, novel, and interesting to people. Only when your work is novel and interesting, others will read your work and they will try to use your work as their base papers, or they can have some collaboration with you. Then write in a citable way. When you're writing a paper, you should write a paper in a citable way. What is a citable way? It meaning is your paper should be clear, it should be organized, and it should be without any grammatical errors so that it will communicate effectively to others. Okay. So remember that your abstract should be particularly clear. When you're writing a paper, your abstract is the main one. When anybody reads your abstract, they should be able to understand what you're trying to say and what is your result from your work. So the abstract should be more clear and concise to ensure accurate indexing and immediate reader comprehension. So your work should be in a citable way. Then research and write about topics that are currently of serious concern. For example, during the COVID period, most of the papers were published only in the title COVID. Okay. Because that is a current serious concern that during the particular years. So try to publish some topics that are currently of serious concern in your area. The next point is establish a relationship between your research and fundamental questions in your field. Suppose when you're writing your paper, you should be able to explain or tell what are the fundamental points needed for that particular your research work. Whenever anybody reads your paper, they should be able to understand easily what you're trying to say and what you're trying to asking them to do some future research in your work. So only when you are able to, your work is able to give some answers for fundamental questions, then it will be very easy for others to understand your work and to continue your work. Then the fifth point is cite your own earlier publications, but it should be relevant to your current work. Suppose now you are doing a network, your research areas network, you are going to try to publish a paper in network. You can also cite your earlier publications if they are published in the area of network and they should be related to your current research work. So you can also cite your earlier publications in your current publication. It is also accepted. Then the next point is cite your peers and include as many references in your paper as possible. So you can also include your friends or colleagues or other professors' works in your research papers which are related to your work so that they can also cite your works in their papers. This will help for increasing the more number of citations. So avoid questions in your titles, but do use colons. Whenever you're writing giving a title for your paper, you avoid a question mark symbol in your for your title, but you can add a colon. So what the service is when you're adding a colon to your title, it increases more number of citations. Okay. So, but you should avoid a question mark symbol in for your title of your paper. The next point is write a review article covering the research literature in your area of expertise. So review articles gets more number of citations when compared to other research publications. It's a survey which shows if you have a review, publish a review article, you get more number of citations when compared to your research publications. So try to write review articles in a particular research area. The next point is publish your work in peer-reviewed journals. So when you publish a peer-reviewed journal is nothing, it will be a quality, high quality, top tier journal. So when you publish a paper in a top tier journal, sure, there will be a high number of readers of that journal. If there is high number of readers, sure, you'll get some high number of citations. So try to publish your work in peer-reviewed journals that are widely read and respected by researchers in your field. The 10th point is use the exact same name for all your scholarly publications. This is the main thing. When you're giving name for your papers, that is author names, try to use the same name for all the papers. In some papers, if you use the first name as the second and the last name in the first, okay. In this other paper, if you use the first name in the first and the second name in the second, what happens? Your citations will move to some other header. So when you're giving a name for your title, that is, when you're mentioning your name as an author in a particular paper, the same should be used in all type of publications which you're publishing. Okay, this is the main thing. Use the exact same name for all your scholarly publications. The next point is use keywords and phrases effectively in each paper. So when you're using some keywords in your paper, use some effective keywords. It should be a common word, and it should be whenever there's somebody Google a particular keyword, your paper should also be listed in that particular list. So use keywords and phrases effectively in each paper and its metadata. If you're using some metadata, for example, some DOI number, it will be a common one. Some other information related to your keywords, it should be an effective one. Then try to publish your paper in special issues. Apart from normal issues, special issues are read by more number of people. So a survey shows if you publish your work in a special issue, it gets more number of readers when compared to normal issues. So try to publish your papers in special issues if possible.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. There is one question related to citation. Can we ask?
No problem, you can ask.
Dr. Neetu is asking, is it possible that we get alert whenever our research paper gets cited if we have Google Scholar profile? Is it possible?
No, what is the use of Google Scholar profile means? It shows, I'll explain you in the later screen about that, how to create a Google Scholar and how to add papers and all. So the thing is, it will list only your publications in that particular Google Scholar profile name. So if somebody sees your work, they can read your work and it will make a citation for your work. That's all.
Okay. So we will get a notification automatically?
In the Google Scholar citations, you can see if your citations are increasing for paper, it shows there.
Okay. Okay, sir.
I'll show you in the latter screens one, please. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Is it clear now?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So in Google Scholar profile, it shows your publication, a paper, for example, how many citations you have got for that particular paper and which year it is published. All the details will be shown in that Google Scholar profile name.
I hope Neetu get her answer.
Shall I proceed, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Please.
Okay. So the 12th point is ensure that the bibliographical and other information about your papers on journal websites and in the scholarly databases commonly used in your field is thorough and accurate. So whenever you're giving some bibliographical and other information about you in a paper, it should be thorough and accurate. So that whenever anybody cite your paper, that particular work will be cited and in an accurate way. Otherwise, what happens if your bibliographical and other information is varying or something is wrong in that, sure, the citations will be not included in your header. The last one is in that particular thing. You publish less number, even though you publish less number of people's papers, don't compromise with quality. The thing is, even if you publish two papers, if they are quality ones, sure, you'll get more number of citations. So before sending any paper to any journal, please use any standard plagiarism checkers. Check the paper with the plagiarism tool and you send the paper to the publishers. Next, how to prepare a quality research paper? So just it's a figure which shows what to do before you're creating a quality research paper. So if I want to prepare a research paper, for example, what I should do? So first I should try to select a topic. Suppose if I want to publish a paper in COVID, for example, I should select the topic COVID. Suppose if I want the COVID, I want to publish a paper in the field of medicines to cure COVID, for example. So particularly you select a particular topic first. then researching the topic, just you Google some, gather some information about your topic. After that, you make an outline first. What are the things you are going to show in that particular paper, either abstract, keywords, introduction, then review literature, then what is this, some experimental research or discussion, then conclusion and references. You make an outline of all these things. After that, you organize the notes. So where it should be placed, a particular topic should be placed, where some explanation should be given or some figure should be given. Just you organize the notes. After that, you start this actual writing. So after writing this, you send for editing and proofreading. After editing and proofreading, this is how to prepare a quality research paper. So next you can see what is meant by a journal impact factor. So most of the journals will say journal impact factor is 1.5 or 1.7 in their websites. Okay. So what is meant by the journal impact factor? You know that impact. So impact means that it shows an impact for a particular product. So journal, this impact factor shows an impact factor journal for a journal. So it is named as a journal impact factor. This journal impact factor is calculated by Clary weight. Okay. So most of the journals will show some SJIF, some DJIF, some all these things. They are not actual journal impact factors. This journal impact factor is calculated by Clary weight. It is mean by that it is only for the papers which is published in Web of Science Index journals. So this JIF is given only for the journals which are indexed in Web of Science. That is Science Citation Index, Social Science Citation Index. So just to keep in mind, journal impact factor is given only for this Web of Science Index journal, which is maintained by, which is calculated by Clarivate. So how they are calculating this journal impact factor? So they will take some 2 years publications. Suppose if they want to calculate the journal impact factor for this year, 2022 for a particular journal, they will take the publications of 2021 and 20 of journals, papers published in the particular 2 years. So first they'll take total number of citations for the 2 years publications divided by total number of times its articles were cited during the last 2 years divided by total number of citable articles in the journal during those 2 years. So suppose if 1,000 for the years 2021 and 20, there are 1,000 citations for a particular journal divided by how many papers are cited, number of papers which are cited will use this journal impact factor for a particular year. So this journal impact factor uses 2 years publications, that is previous 2 years publications, that is total number of citations divided by total number of papers gives the journal impact factor of a particular journal. It means that suppose if they have published 1,000 papers, but only 800 papers are cited. So for that 800 papers, how many citations divided by 800 will give this journal impact factor for a particular year. So this is an example for how they are calculating for a journal impact factor of a journal, that is calculation of 2008 impact factor of a journal. So A and B, so A and B uses this 2006 and 2007 cited journals divided by the total number of citable items published in 2007 and 2006. What I explained previously. So A by B gives this 2008 years impact factor. So this journal impact factor is calculated by only for Web of Science Index journals, and it uses 2 years publications. So this picture shows how they are calculating the same thing. Cites in 2008 two items published in 2007 and 2006 total divided by now number of items published in 2007 and 2006. If you divide both these things, then it gives this journal impact factor, that is 6.125. The next one you have seen about the site score. Now, what is this site score? It is also an academic, it is a measure reflecting the yearly average number of citations to recent articles published in that journal. Now, what is the difference between the previous journal impact factor and site score? So the site score is also using the same way, but it is calculated only for the scopus index journals. The journal impact factor calculates only for Web of Science index journals. This site score is used to find the index, that is the journal impact factor, that is impact factor of scopus index journals only, which is maintained by SOED. So the same process, but this uses 3 years publications. Journal impact factor uses only 2 years publications, but SciScore uses only 3 years publications. See, I have shown an example here. So if I want to find this SciScore for the year 2015 of a particular journal which is Scopus Index, we should take 2012, 2013, and 2014 citations, add it, divided by total number of papers published in the particular 3 years, gives this site score of a particular in the particular Scopus Index journal. So it uses 3 years, but from 2020 onwards, they are using 4 year window. They are using 4 year data. That's the difference. See, I was in the picture, they're showing the site score of a particular journal. It is 2.2, that is 1.8 in 2019. And 2020 it is 1.8, and in 2021 it is 2.2. That is site score. This is mainly calculated only for this purpose in the journals. Then what is the SciMago journal rank? Journal rank. This is one way which is giving a rank for a particular journal. That is just a rank. The rank will be from 1 to 100. So each and every journal which are Scopus index journals, it should be only, they are given only for the Scopus index journal. They were given a rank from 1 to 100. So what they're doing is they're taking only some journals which are high quality ones. They're not considering all the journals. They are considering only these high quality journal one, journals. For that journals, how many citations are just got for the journal? So a journal's HJR is a numeric value indicating the average number of weighted citations received during a cited year for document published in the journal during the previous 3 years. The same process, but it considers only the journals on the basis of prestige, importance of prestige of the journals, where the source they come from, the subject field, quality and reputation of the journal have direct effect on the value of a citations. So this mainly considers only some high quality journals. Based on this high quality journals, okay, they are calculating the SciMago journal rank. So here they are mentioning it as Q index journals, Q index. So you have heard about this Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. So they are calculated only for Scopus index journals. So what is this Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q4? If the SciMago journal rank of a particular journal is between 1 and 25, then it comes under this Q1. If the SciMago journal rank is between, for a particular journal is between 26 and 50, it comes under this Q2. If it is Q3, it will be between 51 and 75. And if it is Q4, it will be between 76 and 100. So the SciMago journal rank is given for the journals from 1 to 100. Which based on the citations from high quality journals. Okay, so if you want to see a SciMago journal rank for a particular journal, you can use the particular URL https://www.scimagojr.com. If you click that, you can see a screen like this. Okay, in the particular tool, that search box, you type the journal name and press the enter key. If you press the enter key, it shows the SciMago journal rank for a particular journal. So the SciMago journal rank will be between 1 and 100. If it is a Q1 journal, the rank will be between 1 and 25. If it is a Q2 journal, the rank will be between 26 and 50. If it is a Q3 journal, the rank will be between 50 and 75. If it is a Q4 journal, the rank will be between 76 and 100. Then what is the major difference between a site score as well as journal impact factor? So the site score is calculated based on Scopus data only. Impact factor is based on Web of Science data only. Site score uses 2-3 year window, but from 2020 onwards, it will be using 4 year window. Impact factor adopts a 2 year window. Elsevier launched a new journal metric site score. Impact factor, a product of Clarivative Analytics. The two companies already have competing bibliographical citations databases in Scopus as well as Web of Science. Next, we are going to see about this Google Scholar metrics. What is this Google Scholar? So most of you have seen this Google Scholar citation, for example. So here, H index, Google Scholar, what is your Google Scholar H index, for example? So this H index was found by a psychist. His name is George H. The first letter H is used for this, okay, of a publication. It's the largest number H such that at least H articles in that publication were cited at least H times. If my Google Scholar H index value is 10, 10 of, if my H index value of Google Scholar H index value is 15, 15 of my papers are cited more than 15. It shows this H index value. For example, if my papers, 5 papers are having Google Scholar indexing 17.963 into, my H index value is, that is 3 of my papers are having more than 3 citations. So what is H score? So H score of publication is a set of top cited H articles from the publication. These are the articles that the H index is based on. For example, the publication above has H score with 3 articles. So those cited 17.916. So what is this H score? That is 3 of my papers are having above this H index value. What is H median? So the median value of this H score values is known as H median. So 9 is this median value between 17.9 and 6. So 9 is H median here. Next, finally, what is H, for example, H5 index, H5 core, and what is H5 median? So if I consider only my 5 year publication, then if I find my H index value, then it's H5 index. If I find my core value only for 5 year publications, then it is H5 core. If I find my median value only for 5 years publications, then it is H5 median. Where's the number of years you are considering? You can mention it is as H6 index or H7 index or something like that. Now, how to see my Google Scholar H index value? Okay, go to Google screen, type your name and click the search icon. Now I type my AV Senthil Kumar in the Google screen. Click my enter screen, enter key. Now I'll get a screen like this. The first it shows AV Senthil Kumar Google Scholar, for example. Just you click it. Now you will get a screen like this. Now it shows my Google Scholar profile. I'll show you how to create the next coming screens. Now it shows my publications. For example, Fuzzy Expert System is the first one. It shows cited by how many people and in which year it is published. Okay. In the right side, it shows a graph. Each and every year, how many, what is my total number of citations? What is my H index value? What is my I-10? It's an I-10 index value. Now, how to find the H index value in Scopus? Okay, go to Scopus screen. And top, you can see author search. You click the author search. You type your name, first name, last name, and your affiliation. You click the search button. Now it shows a screen like this. Now it shows the number of documents, which is Scopus index of mine. And if I want to know my H index value, what I should do is I must click my name. If I click my name, it shows a screen like this. In the screen, the left side, you can see metrics overview. It shows the number of documents indexed in Scopus, how many citations, what is my H index value. This is an old one. Now I have some 78 papers Scopus indexed. Now suppose if you find some of your papers which are indexed in Scopus, but not reflecting in your, for example, it is not reflecting in your count. how to troubleshoot it. So there are three ways you can troubleshoot it. Suppose you know that your 10 of your papers are induction scopus, but only 8 papers are reflecting in the scopus screen. Now, how to troubleshoot it? It means that how to add these two papers in your header, scopus count, for example. One is you try to send an email to the scopus people. That is, I think, supportscopus@elsevier.com. If you go to scopus screen, you can see the email. You send an email to this particular people. You mention all the details. So this is my paper, which is published in that particular journal. They will also ask to attach the paper. You can attach the PDF format of the file to them. You mention all the details. My paper is published in the journal in that particular issue, but it is not reflecting in Scopus. After a few days, it will be added in your Scopus count. One way is you send an email to the Scopus people. The other way is you will have a chat option in that Scopus webpage. You click the chat button. You chat with the people. They will ask all the details about your publication. Then you attach that particular paper. After a few days, your paper count will be reflecting in your name. This is the two ways. Apart from this, this is another way which can use this Scopus author feedback wizard. I'll show you how that. So simply select the author entries and that should be combined and follow the instructions in the Scopus author feedback wizard. Now what I should do for this is, you register the Scopus, you sign in. Suppose I registered my email ID in the Scopus, that is avsenthilkumar@yahoo.com. You should log in. After logging in, you click this author search, you click your name and your affiliation and search the search button. Now we'll get a screen like this. In that screen, so suppose in the screen, author feedback wizard here, in the blue color. In the box, you can see author feedback wizard. You click that one. Now you'll get a screen like this. So you type your name, first name, last name. Then if you find, suppose my name is A.V. Senthil Kumar. I found my name as Kumar A.V. Senthil in some other paper, for example. So what I've done is, I've given the second line, I've given Kumar and A.V. Senthil. Okay. Then you click the search bar button. That is, after clicking this name variant, the small box name variant, when you're typing the second name, you click the name variant. You type the second name, Kumar, as well as A.V. Senthil. Then you click the search button. Now it shows both the names, so the Senthil Kumar, for example, the different names like this. You search, you go down, you see the list. If you find any of your paper in this added to some other names, it is nature. If some of your words or some of the letters, first name, last name is interchanged, the header will be, the Scopus indexing will be moved to some other header. You search all the entire list which shows. If you find any of your papers is added to some other people, you click the orange color button of the particular name. Okay. It will show all the publications of the particular author. You find your paper in that, you select that one. Okay. Then you can use request to merge authors. There will be an option called request to merge authors. What happens? All papers will be there. But in the other author name, you have selected some papers, which is your original paper. It is added to that particular author. If you give this request to merge authors, what happens? The Scopus will reply you, wait for some days, we'll do the process. After a few days, if your work, which is added to some other people, is your is the owner of that particular paper, they will merge that paper to your name. So this is the third way, how to bring your paper, Scopus index paper, which is moved to some other address, that is some other author's name. So these are the three ways where you can troubleshoot your Scopus index publications. Then how to find the H index value of Web of Science? So actually Web of Science is not free. Only the registered or subscribed institutions can use this Web of Science. Okay. So if your institution is having some subscription of Web of Science, you can access it and you can see HS index value. Otherwise, you should use Publons. There's an option called Publons. So see that URL, https://publons.com/account/login. So you create your name. Now you register as a member using the sign in to continue with Publons. You can register as a member on this Publons. After registering, you log into that. If you log in to the particular Publons, you can see a screen like this. You can click track my citations, which is the first option. If you click my track my citations and press enter key, it will show your citations. See, the same way in Scopus, it shows the year where the particular paper is published, the title of your paper, how many citations for that paper, all these things. Okay. So if you want to see your citations, there's an option called H index value and other details. There's an option called summary in the screen. You click the summary button. You can see total number of publications, total number of citations, and H index value, as well as verified editor records. See, the left side.
Sorry to interrupt you.
Tell me, ma'am.
Due to short times, can we take question answers?
It's enough now.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. I'll say about this cloned journals, please.
Okay. After this, we will take question answers, sir.
Okay, just I'll add it for this cloned journals, ma'am. It's very important, sir. Please.
Okay, sir. Please.
So really, I'm very sorry for this delay. So next, I'll give an important topic. This, what is a cloned journal? So cloned journal is nothing. This is a journal which has the same ISSN number, title, logo, as well as the original journal. So most of us, what are doing is, we are trying to publish a paper in Scopus journal, but we are publishing in a cloned journal. This is happening nowadays. These cloned journals are earning crores of rupees by cheating the authors. Now we can see some examples of these clone journals. So they will have the same ISSN number, title, logo of the original Scopus Index journal or Web of Science Index journals. So when you go to this UGC care list, go to the website UGC care list, they are showing some list of journals which are in the clone journals. When you go to the list of clone journals, click group one, it shows a list. The right side will be the original journal. Left side will have the original journals. The journals which are highlighted in yellow color are the cloned journals. Okay, I'll show one example for this. There's a journal called this DRS, Dogo Ransang Journal. The left side is the original journal. The right side is this cloned journal. So in the right side of cloned journal, they are given a UGC catalyst icon and all. So this is to attract or cheat the publishers. Okay, the right side journal is this Dogo Ransang. They are shorted with this DRS and cloned journals. See, the language used is English and Assamese in this original journal. See, they are using the same ISSN number, but the left side original journal is a hard printout copy. The right side is a online journal. See, they are giving a URL in this clone journal, but in the original journal, the URL is not applicable. So this left side is the original journal, and the right side is this clone journal. The same way, the group two also, they are given a list of clone journals. You can go through it, you can see. Group 2 UGC CAR clone journal list. The left side, it is a UGC CAR list original journals. The right side, the yellow highlighted journals are cloned ones. So I'm giving an example for this. There's a journal called Adalia. Most of you have heard about this Adalia journal. The original journal is only Adalia. It is published in Turkish, German, and English. Okay, it is an online journal. So this is the website of this. It's a wrapper is orange color, for example. But see the clone journal, it is named as Adalia Journal. They have added a word journal to this. They're using only language English. They're using the same ISSN number, but this URL is different. See the web page also. So they are given an icon, Web of Science group, to attack the publishers. See how they are cheating. So if you want to check an ISSN number, whether, suppose if you want to identify a particular journal, whether it is original or clone, you can identify by using this ISSN number. Okay. So when the most of the clone journals, when you can click the contact details, they'll only give the address. They'll give you only some boxes so that you can enter your details and click this send button. But in the original journals, they will be giving this address of the particular journal. Even the editorial board members' names will also be some not original names. They will give some different names which are not, the people are not there. So there will be some wrong information in contact details. That is the editorial board also. So when you can go for an ISSN number, we can see the address of the particular journal. Then you can identify the original journal and clone journal. So go to Google. You click ISSN number, check. You'll get a box like this, screen like this. In the first box, key title, you click this journal name. Suppose I click this Adalia, which is the original journal. It shows the ISSN number and the country where it is published, Turkey. So I can identify this Adalia journal's original one. If you type Adalia journal in the search box, it will won't show Turkey. It will show some other information or no information here. So you can easily identify Adalia journal is an cloned journal. This is one way to check whether the original journal or cloned journal. See, this is one journal called Design Engineering. This is a cloned journal. The left one is the cloned journal. The right one is the original journal. The original journal name is Design Engineering Toronto, but the cloned journal is Design Engineering. See, the screen are all same. How they are cheating. So most of all, we are publishing only cloned journal called Design Engineering. See, this is how we can check. When you go to the scope screen, you click this sources on the top. If you click the type the journal name, it shows Design Engineering Toronto. It is from 2012 to present. Now it is inactive in Scopus. Okay. So beware of this Scopus index journal. It may be Scopus index or WebOScience clone journals. If you want to check, just you can chat with the Scopus or WebOScience people. You can ask them whether this particular journal is Scopus index or WebOScience journals, or you can send an email to them to confirm that whether the particular journal is Scopus index or WebOScience. See, this is a journal called Nature Nanotechnology. It is indexed in Scopus from 2006 to present. You can also judge a journal whether it is Scopus index or not. When you click the Scopus content coverage, see the number of papers published per year will be very less in original Scopus index journal. When you consider clone journal, when you click this search for a, it will only show in the screen for a clone journal. But when you go for a journal page, you click some previous issue publications or current publications, they have published more than 500, 600 papers per issue. So from that also you can judge or identify whether the particular journal is a cloned one or original one. So recently I got a mail like this. So they have sent a mail to me. They asked to have a special issue. This I was really happy. So they are told that the publication price is 400 euros and number of days which the special issue we publish will be 20 days. Thus I was happy, but I clicked this journal website. When I clicked this journal website, it went to the original journal website, clone journal website. When I clicked this Scopus ID, it went to the original Scopus index journal website. See how they are cheating. So be aware of this clone journal space. So this is an example for Web of Science clone journal. The original journal is IJDRBC. The first, that is the Nadia, the second one is the original one. The first one is a cloned one. See, the cloned one is the left side. That is, they are having some logo, that is Web of Science and all. But the original Nadia publishes is the original Web of Science journal. See how they are cheating you or they are attracting you. This is a cloned one. They are given some icon, emerging sources, citation, etc. This is the original one. So if you want to check whether a Web of Science index journal is original one or cloned one, go to this Web of Science website. You will have an option search journals. In the search box, you type the journal name and click the search button. If the particular journal is in Web of Science, it shows all the details below that particular search box. Otherwise, it will show, won't show the details. So, request to you all, if you are not having a CV, please prepare it one day. Because what I am saying is, whatever you are doing daily, it should be updated in your CV. What most of we are doing is, only when we are trying for a new job, we are preparing a CV at that time. So what happens, it omits all your works, hard works which is done by you. So prepare a CV, you update it, whatever you do regularly in your CV. So if you have any questions, you can ask. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, sir. Really, it was a very enriched session for us, for all research scholars. And I think they have cleared their doubt also. Still, we have some questions in the chat box. How to find the total number of site table items in a journal? How we can identify it, sir?
Ma'am, it depends, ma'am. For example, if you want to see the total number of citations, I shown in Google Scholar profile. One second, I'll show the screen. See, in a Google Scholar profile, I can see the number of citations. See, ma'am, once again, it's coming this. So this is my Google Scholar profile. So it shows my citations for each of my paper. Okay, so this first one is my paper name, the total number of citations, for example, 51, I think so. Total number of citations in the right box, it's showing. My total number of citations is 14 something. 1459 something. Okay, so it is in Google Scholar. It shows for all the papers you have published. Suppose if you want to see the citations only for Scopus or Web of Science, you should go to the Scopus page. For example, see, this is my Web of Science citations. It is actually only 12. Okay. So if I want to see my Scopus index citations, I should go to my Scopus index webpage. See here, this is my Scopus webpage. I should click author search. I should type my first name, last name, then institution name. Then if I click search, I'll get a screen like this. So in the left side, I can see metrics overview. It shows the total number of papers cited in Scopus, that is 57, and total number of citations, that is 80. Then what is my H index value in Scopus index publication? It is 4. So when you use this Google Scholar profile citation, it shows all the publications citations, but only for Scopus or only for Web of Science, we should go to the particular web page and you should check it. No, it's clear. Ma'am, is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I hope Dr. Neetu have got her answer. And there was one more question again she has asked. Kindly share the names of good journals related to IPR available on open access.
Ma'am, IPR
and open access journal.
Ma'am, sorry, ma'am, there's no idea for that. Please, you can go for Google Scholar and you can check it, ma'am. Please, ma'am.
Okay, no problem, sir. So, is there any question you can post, please, participants?
So, please ask questions. Just I was really sorry for the delay. If you have any questions, just you can ask me. I will clear it.
No problem, sir. Even we say sorry to all the our audience that we have faced today technical glitches
because
in today's session.
Some topics, so what I'm asking you.
No problem. But sir, it was really a wonderful session and I hope all the participants will be get benefited. Now, I would like to invite my colleague, Ms. Manju Kundu, Assistant Professor, KR Mangalam University for the vote of thanks. Manju ma'am, over to you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Very good afternoon to all of you present here. Thank you. We can say that it is such a prayer that cannot be seen or touched. It must be felt by word. I feel honored and privileged to get an opportunity to propose a vote of thanks on this wonderful session. I, Manju Kundu, Assistant Professor at School of Education, on behalf of organizing team, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude
to our esteemed guest speaker, Dr. A.V. Senthil Kumar sir, who clearly mentioned and emphasized the importance of systematic approach for writing research articles, how we do indexing, how much citations are important for a research article or a paper, also gave more tips to increase citations count, how we can check ISSN number online, and also talked about journal impact factor. And he clearly make us understand about the major difference between the site score and the journal impact factor score. Even sir talked about the clone journal and the original journal. Moreover, the way he explained the topic was simply brilliant. His words added more value in the session. So thank you so much, sir. We are really grateful to have you on this session. And special thanks to our participants who showed a great patience today, especially after having or facing so much technical glitch and making this session wonderful, and really appreciate their patience. And special thanks to our Dean, Professor Dr. Tanya Gupta, who has always been a great motivator and supporter for that. So thank you so much, sir.
Sir, we request you to kindly switch on your camera and so that we can have a photo, group photo. And all the participants, you are requested to switch on your camera so that we can capture this moment.
So I think, sir, despite the technical glitches that we had, we had a wonderful session, wonderful interacting with you.
So dear participants, thank you so much for joining today's session. We will wait for the third day session in right time. Thank you so much.